going to show you this tool I created called Pechaflickr. And it's kind of a mashup. And basically, I'm going to use it for my presentation. But it's a combination of this thing that developed in Japan. These architects found when they went to meetings that these architects they listened to gave really boring, long, droning PowerPoints. And they came up with this format called, it's called Pechachka, but I can't pronounce it right, so I always say Pechakucha. But it's 20 slides in 20 seconds each, so they auto-advance, which means you have to be prepared and move fluidly, and you get through a slide deck in about 6.5 minutes. Then there was this other group that did this thing at South by Southwest called Battle Decks. It was kind of fun. They prepared a slide deck ahead of time in that format for people to present that they had never seen the slides before. And they put together these crazy images. And I thought, maybe there's a way I can combine that with Flickr. And I invented this tool called, I call Pechaflickr. And I'm actually going to use it for my presentation. So I'm in the mode right now, and it's going to take maybe a few seconds to load. And look, there's a cow picture. Where's Donna? Purely accidental, because this is random. But you know, when I say presentation, you know, it maybe brings up your connotations, and maybe you've seen some of the boring PowerPoint things, and you know, maybe you've done one. I've done some boring ones. It's not really PowerPoint, but it's kind of the way we approach this sort of mode. So you can think of it as art. So you know, we've got something to show, right? And we really want to make an impact on people, but often we kind of lose our conversational kind of tone when we talk. That hasn't been done today. We've had some great speakers today, right? And largely because they're not there just in that flat monotone. They're relaying stories. You know, they may, you know, they may wear funny hats, but they bring a whole sense of fun to the event just because you feel a little bit more engaged and it feels more personal, like a conversation. We don't get that in presentations a lot. And you know, I remember when I started in Maricopa, you know, I went to this conference in California. It looked like this. Well, except it didn't have a basketball hoop. But it was people standing up on stage, talking with slides, and they were reading their stuff on the slides to me. And I was like, what's going on here? You know, what's the point of this? To a degree, I mean, there is a thing about presentations. I mean, how else could I get up here and relay something like the Flying Karamazov Brothers to you without being able to talk to a lot of people at once? Because if I went around the room and had these individual conversations, it would take me a lifetime. So there is a need to be able to have this format. And it's pretty much what happens when we teach, too. I mean, we're one person. We're not always talking, but we want to communicate and share something with people in a format that's maybe not blinded so much that you can't see the screen. You know, so what I'm proposing is sort of this model of doing something by improv can help just lighten us up. Maybe it's not the appropriate model to use for all our presentations, but I'm going to try to demonstrate what I think is the value of this in the next 14 minutes and 27 seconds. So what comes to mind when I say improv, right? You probably think of, you know, comedians and the improv club, and you know, they're really prepared and they're funny. Well, sometimes they're not funny. But presentations, you know, they kind of often give this bad effect. And people in the audience, and like, I can't see you, but someone's probably yawning out there, and that's okay. And maybe you know, your tongue's sticking out, or you really wish you could roll around on your back and really just relax. And often when you're in the audience, you think you're fooling. I mean, and you know, if you've taught in the front of the room, the stuff that you see in your students' faces, yeah, it happens sometimes. And it's not what we want to do, right? Does anybody want to cause that kind of face to appear? It's not only yawning, it's a cat, and I hate cats. No, cats are fine. And I don't know why most of these pictures, when you do a Flickr search for yawn, come up with cats or guys with painted things on their face or blurry pictures. These are not flattering photos. And so we really wanted to sort of try, you know, even if you're kayaking, you should be having more fun, enlightenment than that. So this idea of improv, I got so excited about improv, I jumped ahead of myself. Is you can think about it as the performance part about what people do at improv clubs, but it's really about being spontaneous. And so when you think about the conversations that you have with friends, when we go to lunch over at the Artichoke Club, we're not going to go through bullet points. I mean, we're going to have conversation back and forth. And I think we just need to rethink the way we do our communications. So we just get a little bit more huggy. We put our arms around each other. We put on funny hats. You know, it's not always appropriate, but I think there are lots of room to sort of humanize our communication, be it up here on stage, be it in the classroom, be it in meetings, be it online, et cetera. And I think improv is a really valuable and terrifying thing. I mean, look at that guy's face. That probably looks like my, is that my picture? No. So, he looks kind of confused, like, duh. But right now, I'm terrified. I don't know what picture's going to come up. There, I've got this rig so you won't see any embarrassing pictures of body parts and naked people, I hope. That would be really bad. But they might be in the dark. I mean, it might be behind the guy, you know, in the red shirt. Maybe there is something there I don't want to see. But there's a little bit of edginess, right? Am I wrong? I mean, you're probably like saying, thank God I'm not up there doing that. That would terrify me. But it's fun to do this. And it can help you get over some of this sort of like proposal syndrome that you get. My first point is, I really love you. Second, I've loved you for 20 years. I have a bar chart. You don't do that when you have these important conversations. And it just seems ironic to me that when we have something important to communicate, we kind of fall back to this kind of stiff mode. And we want to wear better ties and put our arms around each other. I don't see, this is what happens when you get a slide. That's not even a good point to make. But improv, that's what it's about, and it's not about being perfect. And it's about screwing up. There's a lot of power in messing up. I mean, look at these guys. I mean, they're having a good time, right? I don't know what they're doing, but they're being spontaneous. And they're not, like, reading their presentation to you. They're being human and real. And that's what I had this idea that improv, there's a lot that we can learn from it. And not just the performance aspect, really what it can do for our bodies. Okay, everybody do some of this. But what I'm finding this is doing is like, I'm having to think ahead. I got some funny ideas in my head, what I want to say, but I'm trying to match up with a picture. And I'm kind of like, I don't need coffee at all here, folks. but I think there's something going on in terms of getting a tattoo that I might want to do later. Now, that's an example. When you do this, you really don't want to try to just narrate and put captions on things like, okay, I think it's time for a cup of coffee and a plastic glass and a tattoo, and I'm going to lean, and then I'm going to use my hose. You kind of want to get a little bit more, you know, metaphorical and sort of use these images and say, who, me? And just try to practice that skill of trying to talk in the moment, I can't see you. I mean, normally in a group audience, I can see people and I can know if they're like enjoying this or looking at their watch in the program and saying, I'll shake hands with you and then get off the stage. But improv can just be a great form to practice this, even informally. You can do this at home in your bathroom or wherever. You don't need to get up on stage to have this improv experience. But to me, it really is that act of being in front of people that makes it really exciting. So what it can do for you, well, you know, does anybody want more pizzazz? You know, does anybody want less pizzazz? I think pizzazz is cool. I don't know what pizzazz is. But it sounded like a good word. And look, there's that cow again. There's five random pictures that come up. This is the kind of the pause screen while it loads the rest of the pictures. So, you know, maybe we just want to have more singing in our you know, presentations or meetings. Anybody have meetings like this? Why don't we have meetings like this? That looks like a fun meeting. And after the meeting, we're going to get in our old car and go downtown and have pizza at the pizzazz shop. I don't know what pizzazz means, but to me, I get a sense that it's energy, and I want that kind of energy. And it may be scary, you know, it can be frightening. It may make your eyes bulge out. It may make your you know, get varicose veins, but at least you're alive and you're kind of forming these patterns. And you're gonna wanna like recreate patterns in your life that match this feeling. You may wanna like leave Maricopa and start a new career as an exotic dancer. I don't know where I'm going because these pictures are random. And maybe it's just time to go over to the club and maybe have a drink and some bouquets. I don't even know what that is. That's what happens, you know? So it's electric, it's exciting. You're laughing, and you're probably laughing at me because, like, who is this goof up here? But this is some of the things. I mean, you want this kind of, we talk a lot about engagement, and, you know, this guy, is he engaged? He might be engaged to somebody. I don't know. He looks like he's not having a good time. And the future, it's going to be like all modern, but that looks kind of impersonal to me. That's just like a building with shiny things in it. I'm interested in the people. That's where all the action is at. And I don't even know what to say about that, except I want some of that for lunch, okay? Are they serving that over at the club? So now you're laughing and say, you know, how might this is all fun. And when I told Charles I wanted to do this, he wrote back to me by email and says, well, that's kind of a neat site, he says, but what's the practical application of that? And you know, Charles may be still wondering about that right now. But actually, I have seen this used in a couple instances. Several people who run these conference events, it's a great sort of activity to get people sort of fired up, and they get people on stage. And I've communicated with a colleague of mine up at Yavapai Community College. And in between serving Chinese food, they have a Spanish teacher who used this recently in his class. And what he did is he put the word in clothing, and his students get up and take turns one by one practicing their Spanish just to be talking spontaneous in the moment. So imagine in Spanish class, you have to describe chopsticks and Chinese figures. So it's a great way for students or anybody to practice their foreign language skills just by trying things that aren't just the things you learn in language about ordering soup. And maybe it's just, you know, what the heck is that? I've been in touch with a couple other teachers. There's one up in Canada who uses it with eighth grade students, similar in the language area. Obviously, public communication, so people who want to learn to practice their skills. It honestly works. This is kind of hard. Well, it's kind of fun, but one person to go through it all in a group environment, it's really a lot more fun. When I do this as a demo, usually I get five volunteers up here, and I ask them to sort of come and go to Turkey. No, I don't know, is that? It's India, right? And take a trip, but have people take turns. And the interesting thing about that is not only are you responsible for coming up with something, you have to pick up on what the people said before you and establish some continuity and then hand it over during the transition. And that's kind of an interesting process to think about, because then you're sort of working together. So sometimes I've heard people run events where, you know, professional development, and it's for fun, but they get people standing outside on these stone rocks picking the grass because the campus is overgrown. No. Sometimes it doesn't really work to sort of put these things together. But as a way for people just to practice this kind of communication, this impromptu-ness, and I can guarantee you, I've never done this before. I mean, I've practiced this, but I've actually never done this in front of an audience. This is the first time this has ever been done, to use this for a presentation. I've done it as a demo, and I've put this thing together in my house. I built it out of plywood, this website. And then I hope when I get the model right, I can bring it here and have Dave Zamora print me some plastic 3D printed models of it, because the wood is just hard to work with and I can't cut straight. And I don't even know why I'm telling you all this, but it's going with the picture right now. And I'm just trying to keep this thing afloat. And wow, I'm at my last slide. So one of the things that someone asked me once is, you know, why don't you put a timer on the screen? What's the fun is you don't know the terror, you know, when you're going to be in here waiting for the lion to come in and eat you, because obviously you've displeased the emperor. So again, these pictures are coming from Flickr, and it's searching for the tag, and it's finding random images, and there's a bunch of different ways you can configure it. So in this instance, you know, you can have as many up to like 30 slides, and you can change the duration. Some of my slides were a little bit quicker because I wanted to play with the pace. But if you go to this site that I called, by default you get dog. That's just because I have to put something in the box there. But you can actually change it. So if you want to make a show with 10 slides and you want it to go, you know, 15 seconds each, gives you the duration. Actually, it was easy to plan an 18-minute talk. I knew exactly how long each segment. It's kind of cheating when you're doing one of these TED Talks. And then I'm working on some other things that I'm playing around with. I want to, like, so you can actually save it and maybe send it to someone else and say, okay, I did these 10 pictures. Let's see what you can come up with it. So I'm working on some ideas like that. And I think I was just on the way down, I was just musing that I think there's a way. This is running off a web server now, and it takes some server scripts. But I think I can make this run actually off of a local, just a local drive. So you actually don't even need to be running this from a server to have your own standalone. And maybe I can even figure out how to do an iThing app or something like that. But this is the stuff I do. I just get these ideas, and sometimes they're not really like I thought of everything here. This is putting together three or four ideas. The technology behind this is a PHP library that pulls the images from Flickr, and a jQuery JavaScript thing that does the slideshow. And I kind of just like plug the pieces together to put these in. So I don't know if this interests you, or if it's fun, or if you say, well, that's kind of strange. But there's something there that I think is interesting. And to me, that whole practice about trying to create something on the spot, to me, is a real creative act. And one other way that I've used this is I've actually done these in a Google Hangout, because you can share your screen. So I've done this with a group of friends that were in Canada. There was one guy in Japan. And so you can do the same sort of activity in an online space. So it's not necessarily just something you need a green carpet and tech talks to pull this together. And like, I'm so well prepared that like I have an extra minute and 45 seconds. But I'm not going to use up your time. It's a minute you can go to lunch. So thanks a lot. It's been fun.